With this digital transition, and we can have a digital dividend to use those frequencies used by analog TV system be now open to new services. So that I'm very confident we will be able to reach our goals.
We want to make sure that the rollout of broadband infrastructure in Kenya is as cost-effective as possible, in order not for the consumers of those services to pay very highly because they were heavy investments. One of the things that we have done, like for example with the LTE frequencies, is that while many people were thinking of going the auction way because they were looking at making quite some kill out of the digital dividends, we have decided to apportion our 800 megahertz band to the three operators at a nominal fee, so that then they can use much of the money to do the investments into the network, and therefore lessen the capital to invest into that, and probably be able to bring down, you know, the costs. Secondly, what we are doing is that in areas of less accessibilities, we are trying to improve on the connectivity using the Universal Service Fund. But on and above that, we are now thinking in terms of giving a spectrum free for 5 years in those areas for those who would have, those of the operators who would have won to the bid to roll the networks into those areas that do not have any connectivity. And I think coupled with the new policy that the ministry is developing, we believe that there's a number of strategies besides what we have said that we are coming up with, and also including introducing more players. Like, you know, we have brought in a market segment we call the mobile virtual network operators. And we can see a number of them are coming up to provide a number of these services. We now, in terms of broadband, there are certain players that we had restricted them to only certain regions, like what we call in our vocabulary tier two players. Now we are also thinking in terms of giving them some bit of spectrum to not only just concentrate on the last mile connectivity using fiber, but also using wireless, even like fixed wireless and so on and so forth. We believe that that kind of competition coming into force will of course compel the operators also to be able to charge the costs for end user services cost effectively. There are a number of other initiatives we are taking up, and some of them probably I wouldn't commend them now because they are going to take place very soon and they are with different partners. All these are geared towards lowering the cost of even, you know, international connectivity and helping Kenyans to be able to access the net at an affordable price.
We are at the moment reviewing our ICT policy of 2006. And amongst the things that policy is supposed to address is the need to make internet or broadband access available and affordable. And some of the plans that we have in place to ensure that we are able to roll out internet across the country, one of our bigger agenda this year is to ensure that in each constituency, and I think there are close to 297 constituencies in Kenya, that we are going to provide four hotspots in each of them. And we've already engaged the members of parliament. They are going to be utilizing part of their constituency development funds to set up the infrastructure. The government will then ensure that there is the connectivity and the equipment that needs to be acquired. That will then allow the youth especially to be able to access internet, to be able to get content or develop content for whatever purposes they want to use it for. So largely from a policy perspective, those are some of the plans. As soon as we finalize with the policy, it's looking at a lot of other issues the emerging issues in the ICT space, the things that we are seeing happening, the OTTs, the over-the-top transmissions, all those issues are going to be addressed within that policy, will then inform some of the things that will be happening within the sector.